Hi there, this is Tammy with NurseMinder, and in today's video, we are talking about tic-tac-toe. You know that game you used to play as a child? Well, maybe you still play it. We're actually going to bring that forward, and it's another method to analyzing your acid-base imbalances. And we're going to take care of that right after this. Welcome back, my name is Tammy and this is NurseMinder, and on this channel we do everything nursing. So if you're new here, consider subscribing below so that you get the next video when it's released. Welcome back. In this video, we're going to talk about a method of analyzing acid-base imbalances called the Tic Tac Toe method. Now before we can actually start using the Tic Tac Toe, I know it looks like a lot of fun, we are going to get there. We need to recall some of our theory first. So we're actually going to review our normal values for those three elements that we're looking for to determine our acid-base balance. Now, the first thing is pH, the overall acidity of the blood. The normal range is between 7.35 and 7.45. The acid is on the lower end. So if we get lower than 7.35, it becomes acidotic. I'm just going to put a little A on this side to remind me. And if I get higher than 7.45, we call it basic. Now, our PaCO2 stands for our partial pressure of arterial CO2, carbon dioxide. This represents the hydrogen ions. I'm just going to put a little note here. Hydrogen ions are a positive element. The more positive we have, the more acidic our environment. So when it comes to our PaCO2, if I have too little hydrogen ions available, I'm actually basic. And if I have more than I need of hydrogen ions, it's going to become more acidic. Our bicarb is looking at the negative anions. So if I have lots of negative anions, I'm greater than 26, I'm more basic. And if I'm a little deficient, I've got less than 22, I'm going to be acidotic. So now that we've just reviewed those three elements and which side of them becomes acid and base, it's time to look at our tic-tac-toe. So identifying if your acid-base imbalance is respiratory or metabolic, I'd like to offer you this diagram. The PaCO2. CO2 is a reflection of how well our lungs are working. So that would be respiratory. It's a reflection of the respiratory system. HCO3 is a reflection of the kidneys and how well they are able to maintain that positive negative ion, either retention or excretion. And so this becomes metabolic. So we have a patient's results in front of us, a pH of 7.48, partial arterial CO2 of 38, and bicarb is 29. So much like when we played tic-tac-toe as kids, only we used X's and O's then, right? So you would take turns filling this in until somebody got a straight line. We're going to do the same thing here. We're looking for our values to line up to help us determine if we are acidotic or alkalotic. Alkalotic is the term we use when we have too much base in the blood. So if we look at our pH of 7.48, I come back to my normals and I see 7.48 is higher than normal and it's on the basic side. So I'm going to put my pH in here. I also have a PaCO2 of 38. PaCO2, it's normal. It's between 35 and 45. So I'm going to put that in here. And then my bicarb is 29. It's higher, it's also basic, so I'm going to put that in here. Now what I can see is I have my pH lined up with my bicarb. This is telling me that I do have an alkalotic state. I'm just going to write that down.
base means alkalotic. So now I can determine which imbalance I have. The kidneys are driving the imbalance, which is alkalotic. So I would say I have a metabolic alkalosis. The next thing I want to know is my body compensating? So how do I know if it is? Because it is metabolic, our kidneys are driving it, we would expect to see that the lungs help support the body by working in opposition to maintain that acid-base balance in the body. But because my respiratory values are still normal, I haven't seen that shift. Now, if we were to see that shift, let's just change the CO2, and we'll say it's now 32. That's gonna move my lungs over to the acid side. So then the question becomes, is this compensated or is it partially compensated? Now, partially compensated simply means that both systems are working, but the pH has not come back to normal. And when I look at this, I see my pH is still basic, it's still too high. So this would be considered partially compensated. The lungs have kicked in, they're trying to help out. Let's say it's been two more days, sure, why not? So we've redone our blood test and it comes back now and we are 7.38. And we'll leave those two values at 32 and 29. Well, 7.38 is now within normal, so I'm going to move my pH over here. Now, I don't have a tic-tac-toe. I don't have three things lining up, but I do have a normal pH. So this is telling me that these two systems that are out of balance right now are working to maintain a normal environment for cellular function. The question is, which one is still driving the imbalance and which one is correcting? To understand that, we need to know a little bit more about our pH. When we look at 7.35 to 7.45, the middle point is 7.40. If my pH is on the acid side, then we would consider the other matching acid. If my pH was 7.40 and higher towards the basic side, I would look then for the basic system to determine which system is driving the imbalance. So in this case, 7.38 is on the acid side. I would say I have a respiratory acidosis that is compensated. A compensated respiratory acidosis. Let's try another one. Okay, so we have a new patient here and we have our lab results in. Our pH is 7.30, our PaCO2 is 46, and our bicarb HCO3 negative is 29. So let's plunk these in. My pH is on the lower side, it's too low, so we know that's acidic. So we'll put our pH. Our PaCO2 is 46. It's on the higher side, that means I have a lot of hydrogen ions, positive acid. So I know my PaCO2 is acid. I still want to finish this all the way out, though I can't just stop here. My bicarb is 29. Bicarb is base, it's the negative ions, it's high, which means I am basic in bicarb. So I'll put that over here. Now looking at this, I can diagnose that I have a respiratory acidosis and that the kidneys, the metabolic system, is trying to kick in and help bring us back to normal. But it is not compensated yet. So this would be considered a respiratory acidosis with partial compensation because the kidneys have moved into that base side to balance off the lungs. Let's do one more. So in our third example, we have a pH of 7.42, a PaCO2 of 36, and a bicarb of 24. So let's start to plunk those in. You should be starting to recognize your normals. You really should commit these normals to memory. There are three sets of numbers, acid, base, which one's respiratory, which one's kidneys. That should be part of your memorization for this. 7.42, I know this is normal. So I'm going to put my pH in my normal. PaCO2 is 36. I also know this is normal. And my bicarb is 24, which is also normal. Oh my gosh, I don't have anybody with an acid-base imbalance. So the next time they say you shouldn't be having fun at work, you just pull out that tic-tac-toe board and you show them how much fun interpreting acid-base balances can be. Don't forget to comment below. Let me know if this has been helpful. Hit the like button. Share this video with others. There's a bell down there. If you want to hit that bell, you're going to get notified when the next video is released. And as always, I thank you for joining me. And until next time, make it a great day.